This was Paul Feinbaum's headline at the end of yesterday's program. On Saturday mornings, I always ask Paul to end it with write the headline. Today, Alabama's still the one to beat was his big headline of the morning. Paul, I ask you, is there anything that you would change about that headline you wrote yesterday?
Well, I might make it about Maria Taylor and Saban. But no, I think they're still the best team. There are a couple of wrinkles on defense that we'll have to determine later on. But overall, that's exactly what most of us expect from Alabama.
Welcome to our humble radio studio here. Paul Feinbaum with Feinbaum Radio.
The big Sports Center studio.
Well, we're over here in the radio set. Much more smaller, humbler beginning for you. Sorry, I'm not Laura Rutledge. I'm who I am here today. Look, we want to get you in your comfort zone. We want you to take calls because people overreact each and every week in college football. So we're going to actually take some calls here on Sports Center, and we're going to start with Bo from Morgantown on Call Paul.
Paul, your Tennessee Volunteers got all the love this offseason. They land a Nick Saban disciple as their new head coach in Jeremy Pruitt, so they should be all set, right? Well, they just got waxed by Will Grier in West Virginia. So are you ready to crown the Mountaineers as the class of the Big 12?
No, I'm not, Bo. I thought West Virginia played very well. Will Grier is now in the Heisman race. Who isn't on the first Sunday after the first Saturday? But I saw Oklahoma play as well, and I think Oklahoma is the team to beat, not West Virginia.
But West Virginia looked good defensively. Will Grier looked good. It wasn't the greatest start for Jeremy Pruitt in Tennessee. But either way, Will Grier looked the part. Let's go to Leslie now in Baton Rouge.
Hey, Paul, we're getting our tailgate set up for tonight, and I see Matt Canada beating Texas as the interim with Maryland. It's the same guy that Coach O called a hiring mistake last year. What does that tell you about him?
Well, it's a good question. I thought the whole thing last year was just showed the dysfunctionality of that staff. Ed Orgeron, after saying he was going to change, went back to form, and he got rid of Matt Canada, who is a very good coach, and we saw that yesterday. I'm not sure what to expect out of LSU tonight. Steve Ensminger, who hasn't really been up for any jobs in 20 years, he also said Maddie doesn't read Twitter or newspapers. He may after tonight if LSU doesn't win, because it's going to be pretty tough on him.
Yeah, I thought watching Matt Canada last night, he had a pair of quarterbacks that Ed Orgeron transfer out of the program, and they had a players-only meeting. Canada does that yesterday with Maryland. Definitely an interesting story there. Let's go now to Morty in Boca.
Hey, Paul. Morty here from Boca. Listen, Lane Kiffin cannot coach. He's done at FAU. Ridiculous. Absolutely laid an egg versus Oklahoma. Hey, is yesterday's loss going to hurt Lane's chances of landing a Power 5 job next year? Let me know. Thanks, Paul.
Thanks, Morty. We don't have any Mortys calling our show. That was a setback yesterday. I'm a big Lane Kiffin fan, Matt. I think he's done tremendous work, but you have to perform better on that big stage against Oklahoma. I think he will get a Power 5 job. LSU is the place some people have wondered about, depending on what happens tonight and maybe against Auburn the rest of the way. But I think Kiffin has shown that he is an outstanding offensive play caller. He's a good football coach. Yesterday did not help him, though.